Once again, welcome to Seven Coding Academy. We are still on input. If you don't have the general introduction to input in HTML, please go back to my class on input, introduction to HTML, input, and how to use it. Today, we want to do something meaningful. We want to handle our first project using HTML. Like I said, what we want to do is to create a contact form, or I call it a registration form. Let's say somebody wants to apply for your work and you want to get the person's information. How do you do it using HTML? For example, someone went for a job, you go to online, you fill forms and all that. Those forms you are filling, they are prepared by HTML. That is the building block of any website. Though it cannot function now because we've not yet implemented JavaScript. But I will show you how you can create that form so that people can go to your site and create a form. Some people buy plugins because they don't know about programming. If you know about programming, you don't need to go and buy plugins like contact form and the rest of them. You can create it yourself, create simple contact form, simple registration form, simple application form and all that, and even sell it as plugins, okay? So I want to prepare one today, and after that, I also show you if actually when you click on submit, does it really work? So for that reason, I'm going to deal together form and input, not just input, but form and input. In forms, we use forms are like a container for an input. So you see how if you form involve action, form is where you put your JavaScript. But I won't put JavaScript, but to actually create a form now, we submit it and it will go for us and you will see where it will go. You see clean and clear to show that we are not joking. Once again, hop into your system, let's continue. As usual, let's start by creating a form. If you go to my lecture tutorial on forms, go back there, you will see it on my introduction to HTML forms, okay? So I'm handling two things today, forms and input, and they are all covered at the basic. This is advanced level. I want to have a project, a kind of assignment to show that these things can actually work well. So let's continue. The first one to write is form. You know how to create your form. I believe you are no more a baby using HTML. You're now advanced in HTML. And remember what I always say, if you want to understand coding, if you understand programming, don't just do it once. Do it once. Repeat it again, it will sync. Watch me do it. When I finish doing it, then you play the video again and start practicing. Before you know it, you learn all these things. They are very simple, okay? Thank you for listening to Steven. So we've created our form. As usual, bring it down so I can be able to have a lot of space for work. Now, here is where the action comes in. In this action, I want to use one of my contact. Let me use about.html. So if we go straight to about.html, all the point I'm going to fill, we go to about.html. So don't forget what I did, about.html, okay? About.html, that's where I want it to go. So without much ado, without wasting time, let's start with input. And don't forget what you said about input. I will actually paste this in, so it will be quick for me. You two should do the same thing. And make sure you do one after the other. I will explain after pasting so that you get it just completely. What I'm just trying to do is exactly what we did before, okay? We want to create a contact form. Here we come. I will explain in case you've forgotten. I just paste my here. So email after creating form, the next thing is label. Remember, under input, I discussed label. So you don't ask me what is label, how can I use label? So label, we want to start with first name of the person. Now go to the last name of the person. So you remember, label will help you to type a first name. Then if there be a boss, which is the input boss, where somebody cannot put his own first name. So label for first name. Enter first name. You close your label, okay? Then input type, first name. ID, first name. Placeholder, enter first name. I didn't tell you about ID before, but I told you ID is going to use when you enter CSS. And don't worry, because you're not using CSS now, most of our work may be zigzag. It may not really be in a straight line, look like a form, a complete setting of form. But that will go to CSS. You see how you can use CSS to make this thing to be completely good and look like complete contact form, okay? So the next thing I enter is your label again for last name. Repeat the same step. After a label for last name, you come to input. Type last name, ID, last name, placeholder, last name. You remember your BR is for break. This is BR, it's for break. Are you watching my mouse? BR is for break. You break it, you break this set. You come again for the second set, which is phone number, label for phone number. Enter phone number. You close your label. Then input type, phone, ID, phone number. Placeholder, enter phone number. Or enter your phone number, anywhere you put it. Then you also remember, don't forget to break. So that's how you do it until you get to email. Repeat the same process. After that, you break your email. Then come to password. Repeat the same process after that you break your password. Then if you now go to certification obtained, you know, normally it's, we are trying to do someone that come to apply for a work, a CV, okay? So you have to submit the certification as well. Certification obtained, you do that, your input it. Then after that, the date you obtained the certification. There you year obtained. After that, you come to file. File is for you to upload those information, all the certificates. So you can upload it straight away. And we continue after five. We move on again to some questions. You know why I bring in this question? Because of CheckBus. And don't forget, I told you before that if you're using CheckBus, if you use CheckBus and you put label for input, if you put name here and you put name as button and you put name as button again, even if you use up to 3, 4, 5 CheckBuses, it will work. But if you're using radio, they meant you use the same button name for two radio, only one works. You can only tick one. Remember, I told you in my other class, if you've forgotten it, go back to input class. But this is also where I just had an assignment that I was given in that last class. Now, I introduce test area. Test area will enable you to write as many as you can. That's why I put label for introduce yourself and tell us why you consider yourselves as right man for the job. You close your label. Test area name. A test area also come with ID. ID should also be the same thing. Same thing, introduction. Or application or anything you can call it, okay? Then you can put columns in test area. Don't forget, I made my columns to be 30 columns while the row is 10 row. You can also adjust your own to 30 columns, 20, any row column you want. So in test area, you can put columns and rooms together. These are part of CSS, so don't worry about it. We'll get to CSS, we'll explain more about rooms and columns, okay? Then after that, you break it again, so there'll be more space. And lastly, input name button, type of button, submit button. And what do I call the submit button? Register. Because somebody is trying for work, for application for work, or anything you can call it. So if you have done yours like this, if not do it, make sure that it's like this. Once you are through, remember as usual, click on save. S for save. Then let's run it and see if it works. Open with Lifesaver. Wow, everything works perfectly. Okay. Sweet. We have our enter first name. Enter your first name. Let me enter my first name as Emmanuel. Here's my first name, Emmanuel. Next one, your last name. My last name is Juice. I've entered it. It's Juice. Then I now come over to enter your phone number. My phone number is, you know, this. My email address, event20@gmail.com. My password. You can enter anything as password. I can put anything there. Then certification obtained. Let's say BS3 or whatever you obtain. Then your date. Which date do you obtain this certification? I can put a date. Let's say I got mine on October 4, 2022. Let's say 3 days ago. Then I can now upload the form here. You upload the form, upload whatever you want to upload. After that, we'll come over here. Are you a software developer? If yes, tick. I will tick it because I'm of course. Then enter the certification obtained. We've entered that and the year, let's say 2022, then years of experience, you enter it, you now come over and write. This is the test area, you see, give us a no space. And like I told you, you can actually adjust this, you can make it very big, you can make it smaller, anything, you can work on it, anything you want to do with it, okay? You have much things your users can put as much as they want to write, and it will still contain it. Let me say, I am the best man for the job, because I am a web developer. We are just doing this as an instance, okay? It doesn't mean that that's what, just to show that our application works. So after everything, we have our submit button. Remember, let me take you back before we submit. I told you that we want this thing to work. I want to show you a sample that show that it works. So what did I do? Remember when we come to form under action, about.html. So immediately I click on submit, you take me to about.html. Once thing that means that's work. That means I put JavaScript. Then maybe if somebody after registration, you can go to your email, you can any place you want, get to where you are, get to those forms and then use it for work. So I just want this to show that it works. That's why I put my about.html just for you to show that these things work. Okay, and don't also worry about the fact that it's zigzag. If you check very well, you notice that like here is nowhere arranged. That's not an issue. You can actually arrange it on your very well. But when we get to CSS, I will show you how you can arrange these things in a way that will be very neat. Will be a complete contact form that will be okay for people to see and say yes, this is great. So meanwhile, if you're able to get to this stage, congratulations, you just passed your first application, setting up app in using HTML. We just passed our first. What we did now is contact form, creating a contact form, a complete contact form using HTML. And if you're able to get your license, then and you're able to get this at the end of your result, then you pass. Once again, I will tell you congratulations. So let's submit it and see what we are going to go. I click on submit. Wow, this is my about page. Just brought me to about page. That means everything works completely. Okay, everything works completely. So this is our first project. More project will come. Before we do another project, let's fix CSS and probably go to JavaScript, and then we have to build our website, our classic website. That when people will see it, they will marvel and say, Kai, when did you start this? How can you become a professional? So once again, thank you for listening to my class, and see you in my other classes. Later on, we'll revisit this class when we must have gone far in coding, or you call it programming. Thank you so much. See you in my other classes. And don't forget, always subscribe. If I'm making sense, subscribe to my channel, like it, comment, ask questions so I can learn more.